Okay guys, here we go. Today our aim is to serialize an object into an XML string. So first of all, just take down this URL. This is the awesome URL. The guy has written the method using which you can easily serialize object and deserialize object as per your need. Okay, so in order to get this thing going, what I have to do is I have to create an object first, right? So first you need to check out my object, right? So as you can see, I have a request object. Okay, pretty basic. It has got a class name request, it got four fields. As you can see, my class name decorated with XML root, and rest of all the dudes are decorated by XML element. So now my class is pretty much in the condition to get serialized, right? So this is my request class. Fine. Next thing, to fill an object. In order to fill an object, as you can see, I have already created an object. I filled it with first name, last name, salary, blah blah blah. Okay, so now let's talk about the serialization. Serialization is something like, this is my object, I'm going to convert this guy into an XML string, right? So serialize and print the XML. So in order to serialize, what I have done is, actually I didn't do, but the guy wrote some method. I mean, pretty awesome method he has written, which is nothing but a serialization. I mean, this is a method, okay, serialize object. To this method, you pass any goddamn object, okay, and it will serialize your class, and it will give you back the XML string. So let's check that method out, okay? So instead of checking first, let's do one thing. Let's write. So when we write, okay, so when we write, so as we can check, this is my object and I'm serializing my stuff and I'm simply printing it. So I'm gonna run this thing. Okay, I'll explain you like how it works. So as you can see, I got ID, I got name, last name and salary, right? So far so good. But how did this happen? Like, how, I mean, again, you will say this is not an XML. So what I'll do is I'll go to view page source. As you can see, the first line, okay, you can clearly see, like, one second, let me scroll up. So you can see the first line says my first name is Mike and second name is Rolta, right? So basically I got XML, right? But it depends on the browser, how the browser renders the XML. Fine. So as you can see, I got my object serialized and you can see it very much clearly. So now let's dive into this method. What happens inside this method? Go to definition. This is a method, as I said, I mean, you can check out this URL anytime you like. The guy has given four methods. The guy has given four methods, serialize, deserialize. Apart from that, two other methods given by him in order to get the things done very smoothly, right? So what this method is all about, this method, first of all, returns a string, takes the object, it takes the type. I mean, any type you pass it to this method, it will accept it. Fine. Now our aim is to return the XML string, right? So we are initializing. Either it is null or string.empty, it's fine. Next is, we require memory stream. Why stream? We'll talk later. Next thing, we are here for serialization purpose, right? So I mean, the .NET has the inbuilt XML serializer capabilities, in which first of all you have to type the you have to pass the type of an object which you want to serialize. Then once the instance is created, the instance itself has a method called as the serialize and deserialize method. So this serialize method requires an writer, right? The XML text writer, this method is required. So what are we doing is, you know, we are creating a XML text writer, and which requires a stream and an encoding. Now how can I explain? Let's go to F12. If you go down there, you see this is the inbuilt class of XML text writer. Okay, as you can see, on our method we have a stream and we have the encoding, right? Stream is W, the stream which you want to write. Okay, so we want to write the script, the stream, right? So what are we doing is, let me go back to that method back. So what happens, this is a text writer. I mean, like, we are passing the memory stream and we are passing the encoding, which is UTF-8. After the serialization, this text writer has, you know, in the base stream, it has a memory stream. I mean, it holds the data. It has a serialized data, which can actually, we can, you know, save it to some place, we can do. But right now we are holding it to the stream, right? So XML takes writer dot base stream, and then we fill the whole data into a memory stream. Then we have one more method which requires memory stream. Basically, this method will accept the byte of array. Okay, once the byte of array we get, we have a function called encoding dot get string, and whatever the byte of array we got, based on that it will generate the XML. And the XML which you saw, it was there in the browser, right? This is the XML what you get. So as simple as that, right? So we have the XML now. Now the situation changes. The situation tells me, okay, you got me the XML. Now do one thing. I'm giving you the XML and give me my object back. And my object is what? Request. Okay. So let me, one second. Hopefully you are with me so far. So what I'll do is, as you saw, this serialize method, there is a one more method called as deserialize method. Again, it requires an object. Let's go to a definition. In this, you see, I'll be passing a string of an XML. Now, from where I'll be passing that? If you look at this example, what I've done, I created an object, I got my XML serialized string back, and simply this serialized string, I'm passing back in here. Okay, so let's again go to definition. So I'll get the XML string, then along with that, I pass the type, what type I'll be getting back, right? So in our case, we are getting the type back as a request. We're getting a standalone type back right now, fine? So if we go in util and we check that serialize, we need to initialize again with the type of whatever type you're passing. Then memory stream is equal to new memory stream. Then there's a function, you know, which gives you a byte array back. Okay, which gives you a byte array back once you pass the XML string. There's again a method called encoding.getBytes. You give them XML, gives you the byte array back, right? Once you get the byte array back, you just initialize your writer with a memory stream where you want to write. Okay, and encoding as again, by default, I guess UTF-8, it picks up automatic. The encoding to generate, if the encoding is null, it writes out stream as UTF-8 by default. In our case, we are using the UTF-8 itself, right? Now we use the deserialize method. Deserialize method requires a stream which we already have in here. Once you provide the memory stream, that's it. It returns you the type, whichever type you are expecting, like, you know, from your end. It comes back here. Okay, and gives you an object of this type. And then you can check, like, if this object dot first name has arrived, you can check if it is null or not null. If it has a data, then start printing. So let's run again. Okay, so as you can see, one second, let me just to override the confusion, I have to remove this guy. This prints the XML, right? Stop. So you should see this method only. X, I'm adding X just, you know, so to realize the .NET is not printing, it is our method which is getting printed. So you see, first name is Mike, last name is Rota. What exactly I did, I just passed my XML string which I received here and over here, and it got the things deserialized. Now why I'm doing this, imagine in the future, you know, right now I'm serializing in front of you, so you're getting the, I mean, serialized string. In the future you get the XML as a string, and you need to create the bunch of objects, right? So now what will you do? So this is the guy who comes into the picture, who can help you right away. Now this is not limited to only request. It is again has an option. Okay, I'll do one thing. I'll create the same session for multiple objects. So I guess that would be all. I hope you got the idea that we get our object back, right? Okay, thank you.